Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve problem 4-100 that is taken from chapter number 4, Axial Load, and book name is Mechanics of Material by RC Hibbeler. So statement is the rigid beam is supported by a pin at A and two steel wires, each wire having diameter of 4 mm. If yield stress for the wire is 530 MPa and modulus of elasticity of steel is 200 GPa, determine. The first part is intensity of distributed load W that can be placed on the beam that will cause only one of the wire to start yield. And in B part, smallest intensity of distributed load that will cause both wire to yield. For the calculation, assume that steel is elastic, perfectly plastic. So you can see this is the beam. Clear, there is a pin support at point A and at point B and C, there are two steel wires of having diameter 4 mm. And there is a distributed load acting on over the whole length, which is W. So you have to find this W for one of the wire to yield. And then in second part, we have to determine this W for both wires to yield. So let's start with the solution. So first step is that if you remove this pin support at point A, so you will be having a vertical reaction force, and this will be RAY, as well as there is a horizontal reaction force which will be equal to RAX. And similarly, if you remove this wire BE, so there will be a vertical reaction offered by this wire EB or BE on the beam. And same is the case for wire CD, that it will act a vertical reaction force on beam which equal to FCD. And there is a distributed load of magnitude W. So when this distributed load is converted into a point load, so it will act at the middle of this beam and the magnitude will be W into the length. And length is 400 plus 250 plus 150 is 800 millimeter, which will be equal to 0.8 meter. And its unit will be Newton per meter. Clear? Now we'll find this FBE and FCD by using equation of equilibrium. So first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all moment about point A is equal to zero, and taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So about point A, the first moment will be FBE, and perpendicular distance is 400, which is 0.4 meter, and it is producing counterclockwise, so it will be positive. So I will write FBE multiply by 0.4. The second moment that is produced due to FCD and perpendicular distance is 0.65 meter, and it is also producing counterclockwise movement, so it will be positive. So I will write plus 0.65 times FCD. And the last moment that is produced due to this load and perpendicular distance is 0.4 meter, and this is producing clockwise, so it will be negative. So I will write minus 0.8 W times 0.4 is equal to 0. So 0.4 times FBE plus 0.65 times FCD is equal to 0.32 times W, and this will be your equation number 1. Now from our observation, the wire CD will yield. So what we are going to do, we will find this force in CD due to yielding will be equal to yield stress into the area. So yield stress is given as 530 MPa. So 530 into 10 raised to power 6 multiplied by area. Since it is circular, so pi by 4 into d, which is 0.04 meter, and its square, that will give you FCD. So when you calculate, this FCD will be equal to 6.660 kilonewton. Now you have this value of FCD, so I will draw, let this was the initial beam, clear. So this is your point A, this is your point B, this is your point C, and this is your point D, G. So due to this load, the beam will deflect like this. So this B point will come toward new point, which will be B dash, C point will move toward new point, which is C dash. So you can see we have the distance between A and B is given as 0.4 meter. From B to C, it is 0.250 meter. And from C to G, it is 0.150 meter. Clear? So we have, now you can see we have here, we will take two right similar right angle triangle. One is this one and another one is this one. So distance between B and B dash will be equal to delta B E, and from C to C dash is, it is delta C D. So by using this, distance will be delta G. So by using similar triangle, triangle E, this is the triangle E, B, B dash, and triangle A, C, C dash. So the ratio of their sides will remain same. So if we take delta B E divided by 0.4, so what I am going to do is that I take this side and divide by this. The ratio of these two sides will give you delta BE divided by 0.4. And it will be equal to, if you take this right angle triangle, clear? So delta CD divided by 0.65. Delta CD divided by 0.65. So from here we will get delta CD will be equal to 1.625 times delta BC. Now we know that change in length is equal to force into length divided by A into E. So we will write this delta as FCD into LCD divided by area into E is equal to 1.625 times del BC will be equal to FBC into LBC divided by area into E. So again, you can see both lengths LCD and BE both are 800. So it will cut with this, clear? Similarly, area will be same and modulus of elasticity is same. So what we will get is that FCD is equal to 1.625 times FBC. Clear? Now you have this equation. Let this equation is equation number 3. So put equation 3 in equation, put the value of this, let this is your equation number 2. So put equation 2 in equation number 3. So when you put the value of FCD, so FBC will be equal to FCD divided by 1.625. So 6.660 divided by 1.625 will give you FBC. So FBC will be equal to 4.009 kilonewton. And let this is your equation number 4. Now put the value of equation 2 and 4 in equation number 1. This is your equation number 1. So putting equation 2 and equation 4 in equation 1. So how we will put is that 0.4 times FBE. Okay, FBE. So this is delta BE. Okay, so this is BE, not, this is same as, this is not BC, this is BE. Clear? BE. So delta BE. So 0.4 FBE, so 4.009 plus 0.65 time FCD, so FCD is 6.660 is equal to 0.32 W. So from here, what we will get, W will be equal to 18.7 kilonewton per meter. So this is the value of distributed load for one wire to yield. Clear? Now we'll move toward our second part, and in second part, both wires yield. So if both wires yield, so FBE will be equal to FCD, and that will be yield stress into area. So what is the yield stress? That is 530 into 10 raised to power 6 multiplied by area. So area of wire is pi by 4 into 0.004 square. So it will give you FBE is equal to FCD, and that will be equal to 6.660 kilonewton. Now put FBE and FCD in equation 1. Equation 1 is this one. Clear? This one is the equation 1. So when you put it, so you will get W will be equal to 21.9 kilonewton per meter. And this is the value of distributed load for both wires to yield. And that is all about this problem 4-100. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Also share my videos with your friends and help me in growing my channel further. Thank you for watching.